A lot of this stuff's been up there 15 years, maybe more, 20 years, gathering dust. Look how much light there is there now. I've seen about a dozen pieces that I want to keep. Most of it's junk. Came. That's Y section for going round lead windows to go in double glazed units. Let's see if I can extend this extractor down there, because that creates a lot of this sawdust. Got some 3-inch pipe. There, look. Yeah. Cool. I need them. Gaffer tape, I think that'll sort that out. Right, so that is going there. A little bit of soapy water helps these go together. I'm going to need it especially to get that one on up there. That is going to go in there. At some point, I can't do it now because it's locked down, but I might just run 4-inch all the way along, and when I extend the end there, I'll just take it on further. 24-volt SDS. Still works. Surprises me. There's my cordless saw there, collecting crap. Found me Yankee handle split, so I might one day make another one on lathe. I'm cutting this off because these things are cemented on, can't get them off. I use these because they've got a nice flat profile, so when the shavings go through there they don't get caught. Gaffer tape, look. So I just got a squirt. See a little mark there, look. And that one there. So I'll transfer that over, or I'll just drill it through from this side. Might be able to get through there. It's a bit small, but I've got a nice long bit. I think I got this from Screwfix. It's quite a bit longer than normal bits. This means I can get in without the chuck getting in the way. That's the plan anyway. Simple as that. hate that. These are M6, so it should be a 6mm bit. I think I'm going to go 6.5. Just give myself a little bit of clearance. So I'll do. So I need to make a blast gate here. I'm gonna just connect a bit of pipe to it and see if I can suck up all this. I'm gonna give it a go, see what it's like. But like I said, I need to make a blast gate. And I'm gonna rewire my extractor. You see, it's right down there in the corner, and if there's junk in the way, it's a pain in the neck to get to it. So I'm gonna run another switch to there. I think I need to dig into it. Get my screwdrivers out, have a look inside. But run a switch to where, and then two-way switch it over here, I think. And I don't have to walk over there every time this comes on. Because my hoover there has got an auto switch that turns it on as soon as you start cutting.
Right, extractor's on. See the bag on top? I shut this. That's a narrow pipe, so it'll restrict it. I'm going to shut this. You can hear the restriction. I can hear the difference, so I need to leave that open just a little bit, I think. Just to make up for the difference in pipes. Right, this even smaller pipe is going to restrict that even more, so we'll see. Bit loose that, gaffer tape. I've got that hooked up. It's a little disappointing actually. I've had to push that in a bit. So push it all the way in. Still not that good. It works, but I can hear that the machine there isn't happy.
That 3 inches coming off. It's no good. So forked out. Got some 4-inch pipes and some fittings. Shiny, shiny, shiny. Cool. Thank you very much, Paul. That'll be interesting to play with. this, but just for the moment. at this to go down there to join that, and then I've got some flexi pipe to go up to the machine here, and these little bolts can't get in, can't get my arm down there, so I've got no choice, gonna have to self tap them on. I didn't want the little projections on the inside, but hopefully sawdust won't collect on it. We'll see. MDF, dustiest of all the woods.